All of us want to design eye-catching presentations with beautiful visuals and layout. But how do you do that if you're not a designer? In this video, I'll share with you how I use PowerPoint AI Designer, also known as Design Ideas, to design my slides and ultimately save me time and help me create better presentations. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, if you have Office 365 subscription and you're running PowerPoint on your PC, then go to Design tab and click on Design Ideas at the right side of the screen. If you are running PowerPoint online, then go to Design tab and click on Designer. Design Ideas is a new tool in PowerPoint that uses the words you type, images you provide, tables, etc. to generate designs for you. Think of it as a personal presentation designer. Now let's take Design Ideas for a spin. I'm running PowerPoint online, so I'll start by typing the word hello and then I'll click on Designer to see the designs it generates. Now I can scroll down to see more options, and if I'm not satisfied, I can click on see more design ideas. Now, depending on your connection speed, it could take a while to load the designs. But once you find something you like, I like this one, I'll click on it. And voila, the design has been applied to this slide. Let's try another example. This time we want to design a title slide. Go to Insert tab, New Slide, and then click on Title Slide. I have the text already, so I will copy and paste and see what designs it generates. If you create a new slide and you don't see new design suggestions, close Designer and open it again. I can scroll down to see the options and design ideas will continue to generate new designs. When I find the one I like, let's see. I like this one. I just have to click on it. If I change my mind, I can click on another suggestion. So for example, let's say I need another design. Let's try the first one. Again, depending on your connectivity, it might take some time. I'm going to switch back to the first design I selected, this one. Ladies and gentlemen, our title slide is ready. Let's preview the slide. Oh, look at that. Just brilliant. I want the next slide to display a list of items. For example, table of content. So I'll go to Insert tab, New Slide, and I'll click on Title and Content. Again, I'll copy and paste the text. I'll go to Design tab and then click on Designer. Let's take a look at the suggestions. I'll click See More Design Ideas to see more suggestions. And let's see what we have. I'll go with this one, so I'll click on it. Just look at that. Table of content is ready. Did you notice something about this design? The items contain words such as speech, debate, speaker, etc. And Design Ideas recognizes these words and intelligently generates design to match the items. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Coming up later on, I'm going to show you my two favorite use cases for design ideas and how you can use them in your presentation. So stay tuned for that. But first, like this video and comment down below what other questions you have about PowerPoint design.
Most presentations have a list of items. Design ideas can convert your list to smart heart and improve their look and feel with icons. Let's check it out. I'll start by inserting a blank slide. Then I'll copy my list and paste it here. This is a simple list of expenses. I will increase its font size and let's see what design suggestions we get. I'll go with this one. It recognizes the items in the list and associates them with appropriate icons. That's just beautiful.
Designing timelines in PowerPoint can be difficult and time-consuming, and that is why it is one of my favorite use cases for design ideas. Let me show you how.
To illustrate, I'm going to create a timeline of events during the year. I'll copy and paste the event on this blank slide. If you check on the right of the screen, you can see that Designer intelligently generates timeline for our event. I'll click on the first one. And we have a timeline ready in less than 60 seconds. If you wanted to design this by yourself, it would have probably taken a couple of minutes. So that's a lot of savings in terms of time. Now let me show you my second favorite use cases. Image gallery is my second favorite use case for design ideas. I will insert some photos from stock images. I'll select a simple gallery. Designer has automatically resized all the images to fit the width of the slide. If we want to use a different layout, for example, make the primary photo larger, we just have to scroll to what we want and click on it. For example, I want to try this. Look what design idea has done. It's just beautiful. So if you have images to display on your slide, take advantage of design ideas.
Are you open to work? Then click on the screen right now to learn how to create a video resume in PowerPoint. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to this channel so that you can get notifications when I post new videos. I'll see you in the next one.